about the floods. When you say pledge, you have to be conscious, aware what you are saying. Otherwise it is useless. Okay.
Hi.
Hi.
For Central Austin Sanglinton High School.
Central Austin Sanglinton High School.
Coming to be.
Coming to be.
Vigilant.
Vigilant.
And bear in mind.
And bear in mind.
At all times.
At all times.
Arise to myself.
Arise to myself.
And my colleagues.
And my colleagues.
From
COVID-19.
I promise to take
all necessary precautions
that prevent the
spread of
this deadly virus. I promise to follow
and
encourage others to follow
the key
COVID appropriate behaviors. So always wear a mask or a face cover.
Especially in public places.
To maintain a
minimum distance of
6 feet from others. To wash my hands. Frequently and thoroughly.
With soap and water.
Together.
We will win this fight.
Against COVID-19 virus.
Birthday today. Did you all wish it, ma'am? I want to tell you before we begin our class. The first is, we should never allow anybody come close to us or behind us, in front of us, so close that they breathe on us. That's very essential. You should never go so close and breathe on the others. And we should never allow others to come so close and breathe on us. Okay, we do not know. We should keep a respectful distance. They say 6 feet, but you see where you are safe. You maintain yourself. Nobody is going to protect you. We have to protect ourselves. Just because you are putting on mask, does not mean you are safe. You have to keep distance. Okay, that's first thing. Secondly, whenever you are wishing somebody for birthday, at least that time you shouldn't be funny, because that will be disrespect to the person whom you are greeting. When you are greeting, we are acknowledging the worth of that person. We are respecting the dignity of that person. You might fun, joke, play with that person all through the year, but when you are greeting, you have to do it with respect. Okay? Because that's how you give due honor to the person. Celebrate itself means to do due honor. it means to do honor, to give due honor. So do not ever sing with sarcastic way or funny way, because that's not the way you expect. See now. And in 10th class, whenever you are celebrating birthday, for one lifetime, you are wishing that person. Because next year, you may not be there in the same situation. This is the last chance. See now. So you shouldn't give an impression that you don't respect that person. These are simple things, but most valuable things in life. Who bothers whether you get 500 plus or 700 plus? Who wants? You want it. See now. But people all want to be respected. So, irrespective of people's merits, we have to be kind and considerate in recognizing the dignity of the person. Not because he is celebrating today, but this we must always remember. Okay, those are the two things I wanted to tell you. And you know, the fourth act is done, and in the workbook you have lots of annotations. I will pass on the notes for you. You are supposed to copy down in your workbooks. I should have done yesterday, but I'll do it today. I'll send it by your WhatsApp class. I'll put it in the class group, and you can copy it. With that, I will be completing third and fourth acts. I have already passed on to you the third act. The fourth act, I will do it today, and you need to copy them onto the workbook. One advantage in copying down to the workbook, when you do it with attention, you will learn. Okay? These are some appropriate answers. They need not be the best answers. What you write will be best. These are simple guidelines for you to answer. In that direction you must answer. You don't need to learn by heart. But you have to write in good vocabulary and with correct grammar. So practice. What we are going to give you is simple some help. Who is there? Come in. So we will quickly glance through the fifth act. Though you don't need to study that, but it is good to know the completion of the story. So Portia and Bassanio, they are arguing about the ring. And that's one reason why I wanted to take this Act 5, because the ring story will get completed only in the fifth act. Okay, I will take it from 180. Portia. Sorry, we have done that. Okay, 195. Portia, what ring gave you, my lord? Not that I hope which you received of me. I hope you did not give away the ring which I gave you. Bassanio, if I could add a lie unto a fault, I would deny it. That means I must say the truth. I must say the truth, not lying. I must say the truth that I have done a fault, a mistake. But you see, my finger hath not the ring upon it. You see, my finger is empty and it doesn't have the ring. it's gone. It is given away. Portia, even so void is your false heart of truth. Even so void, void, vacant, empty, vacuum is your false heart of truth. By heaven, I will never be your wife until I see the ring. She is promising that she will not be his wife until she sees the ring. Nerissa, you know, Portia is putting up the action. She is just pretending. She is acting. She is the person who has received the ring. We all know that. But Bassanio does not know. Because he is on the stage. He is one of the characters. Characters do not know what is happening. But the audience and the readers know what is happening. Because the dramatist is narrating everything to us, including their intentions. Okay, Nerissa. Nor I be yours till I again see mine. I also will not be your wife unless I see the ring. To whom is she saying? Gracia, no. Bassanio's, sweet Portia, if you did know to whom I gave the ring, if you did know for whom I gave the ring, and would conceive for what I gave the ring, and how unwillingly I left the ring, when naught would be accepted but the ring, you would abate the strength of your displeasure. Dear Portia, if only you know, you will... That power of knowing will reduce your displeasure, will abate, satisfy your displeasure. If you did know to whom I gave the ring, if only you know to whom I have given this ring, and if you did know because of whom I have given the ring, and would conceive for what I gave the ring, and conceive, understand the reason behind in giving the ring, and how unwillingly I left the ring. It's not that with the whole heart at one stretch I had given away, but I had to give it away at a further advice that he had to give away the ring. So if you know all these reasons, I think, Portia, you will not be so angry with me. Portia, if you had known the virtue of the ring, we can say the importance of the ring, or half her worthiness that gave the ring, or half of the worthiness. Portia is totally worthy. Even if you take she is not fully worthy, at least half of her worthiness, if you recognize, you would not have given the ring. Or your own honor to contain the ring. Your own, if only you know what is your value, you would not have given the ring. You would not then have parted with the ring. You would not have given the ring. But what man is there so much unreasonable? If you had pleased to have defended it with any terms of zeal, wanted the modesty to urge the ring, the thing held as a ceremony. So, who is that man who will not understand the importance of this ring? It is a ceremonial ring. It is not just an ordinary ring. So, if that man were to know to whom you have given this ring, the value of this ring you would not have taken. Nerissa teaches me what to believe. Nerissa teaches me what to believe. I'll die for it. But some woman had the ring. I'll die for it means I am quite sure. Promise on me. OK? Okay, I will die for it. That means I am quite sure that the ring is given to a woman. That means there is somebody in your heart. Bassanio, no, by mine honor, by promise on me, madam, by my soul, no woman had it. He doesn't have any thought about such kind of things. So he is denying totally. But a civil doctor, a lawyer, which did refuse 3,000 ducats of me, who has refused the offer of 3,000 ducats from me and begged the ring and asked for this ring, the which I did deny him, I also denied it, and suffered him to go displeased away, and I pained him to go away without the ring. Even he that had held up the very life of my dear friend, and that lawyer, that young doctor, was such a generous soul. He saved the life of my dear friend Antonio. Even to him I had to deny the ring, and he had to go away with pain. What should I say, sweet lady? What shall I say? My dear, I was enforced to send it after him. I was forced. Hey, what happened, Mr. Sohail? You are not well? Why did you come? You only man. What's your name? Sohail. You are not well? Well, then for what you are coming here to dream? Sit right. Take the book to your hands, man. Hold the book. That fellow's wife died, and he is. I could say in a Delhi in Telugu, man. As if you have lost somebody. You are carrying the world or what on your head. Yeah. Take the book into your hand. Hey, you are all listening only, man. You are not taking down anything. I told you, this is not a drama. You are not watching a TV show. I was enforced to send it after him. I was beset with shame and courtesy. My honor would not let ingratitude, because Antonio himself had asked, give it away, that ring. And therefore, to save his shame, his self-dignity, and also to be courteous. And he could not say no to Antonio, because Antonio got into all this trouble because of him. So he thought that is the way he can be grateful. That is the way he can express his thanksgiving, gratitude to him. So much bismirit, so much has happened. Pardon me, good lady, for by these blessed candles of the night, by these blessed candles, so at their place, on a side table, there were candle stands, candles were there. By these blessed candles, by these sacred candles of the night, had you been there, I think you would have begged the ring of me to give the worthy doctor. Even if you were to be there on the spot in the court, you also would have said, okay, it's all right, give it away to that young lawyer. Portia, let not that doctor ever come near my house. She says, let that doctor, that young lawyer, ever come to my house, since he hath got the jewel that I loved. since he is possessing the ornament, jewel, the ornament that I loved and that which you did swear to keep for me. You have sworn, you have given an oath, promise that you would keep that for the sake of me, for my sake. And I will become as liberal as you. I will not deny him anything I have. So I will also be very generous with him. I will also give him away what you have given me. You gave away what I gave you, and I don't have any value for you. And you have given me, I will also give it away. You have no value for me. But all these out of pretense, they are not, they are on play. They are playing with each other. Sorry, Bassanio is sincere, but Portia is simply at play. She is playing on like vain. Nerissa to Graciano, nor I his clerk. I will also not forgive that clerk. Therefore, be well advised how you do. Leave me to my own protection. Antonio, now Antonio is speaking. I am the unhappy subject of these quarrels. I am the main reason for all these quarrels. Portia, sir, grieve not you. Sir, you don't be unhappy about this. You don't be sorry about this. You are welcome. You are welcome to my house, notwithstanding. Notwithstanding means even then, in spite of. Okay? Even then, all these things have happened, even then, you are most welcome. In spite of these things happen, you are still welcome to the house. Bassanio, Portia, forgive me this enforced wrong. Portia, please pardon me for this enforced wrong. I didn't do it by myself, but it was enforced. I am forced to, I am pressurized to do that. And in the hearing of these many friends, in the hearing of all these friends, I swear to thee, I promise you, even by thine own fair eyes, wherein I see myself, even in your own eyes, through your own eyes, I see myself. Portia, mark you, but that in both my eyes, he doubtly sees himself. Sorry, he doubly sees himself. In each eye, one swear by your double self, and there is an oath of credit. We'll read the paraphrase. Hear what he says. He sees himself twice in both my eyes, one image of himself in each eye. So he swears by an appropriate oath by his double self. Is that an oath to be believed? He is for outside, external appearance one, and internally, he is another self. There are two selves. Okay? So, how to believe him? He is not integrated person. Integrated person. Integrated. Integrated means both outside and inside one. Okay? A person who is inside and outside one. Some people externally they appear very, very humble, but interiorly they are very, very proud. Some people appear to be very, very friendly, all for you, but interiorly they are your enemy and they try to cheat, deceive. So it is a split personality, outside one form and inside another form. Integration is bringing together both aspects, both external and internal together, one reflecting the other. That means if he is externally a good friend, internally also he is a good friend. He values you. He has no intention of cheating you. But Porsche is blaming Sanyo that this fellow is not an integrated person. He is a split person. Now which one to believe him? Sanyo, nay, but hear me. No, please hear me. Pardon this fault, and by my soul, I swear, by my soul, by myself, by my heart, we can say. Soul is different from heart. Okay. So by myself, I swear, I nevermore will break an oath with thee. I'll nevermore break any promises that I make. Basanyo is like us. We easily break the promise. Every day, we get up saying that we will impress the others with our good behavior. But in the morning itself, you shout out to your mummy who comes to wake you up. At the first instance itself, you break the promise. But today morning I wanted to tell you about shining your shoes. Don't come with sandals and slippers to the school. These are not holidays. You are coming to proper school, therefore come with a proper uniform. And shine your shoes, man. You are of young adults. You are. Lots of people are looking at you. What impression you are leaving? What impressions are you leaving? People do not ill-treat you because they have low opinion about you. Their opinions are formed by repeated appearances. By your repeated appearances, I form the opinion about you. Of course, we shouldn't bother about those opinions. But we are living in a society. We have to appear. We have to not only appear, we have to be gentlemen. Be neat and tidy. We have been insisting that your shoes must be shined daily. Daily we have to shine our shoes. Our face must be seen on the shoes. So neat you must be. And how many of you have shined your shoes? Last year you left and kept there the white canvas, and today you put on and come all fully dirty. We don't need new things. We need to keep them tidy, clean. We don't need new things. What you have, you use it. Clean it and use it. For some, the white sock, the white shoe, they never even wash or clean. Just to wear it and come. Finally, at the end of the year, it will turn out to be black shoes or brown shoes. You are growing up. Which girl will look at you, man? And you want only face is bright. Down? You think people don't look at your shoes, your clothes? Be neat and tidy. Okay. Antonio, I once did lend my body for his wealth. I did once lend my body. He lent his body because he agreed. He allowed Shylock to take one pound of flesh from his body. Which, but for him, that had your husband's ring. Which, but for him, who? The young doctor. If not for him, I would have lost my body. Had quite miscarried. I dared to be bound again. Upon my soul, upon the forfeit, that your Lord will nevermore break faith advisedly. I believe your husband Bassanio will never more break his promise. He is a very gentleman who stands by his promises. Antonio is assuring Portia about the steadiness, the faithfulness, the fidelity of Bassanio. Portia, then you shall be his surety. Okay, you can be his guarantee. Surety means guarantee. Give him this and bid him keep it better than the other. So she is giving Antonio the ring. Ask him to keep it better. Antonio, here, Lord Bassanio, swear to keep this ring. Promise to keep this ring tight on your fingers. Bassanio, by heaven, it is the same I gave the doctor. Bassanio is coming to his senses now. So he is realizing that this ring is same as that he has given to the doctor. Portia, I had it of him. I took it from him. Pardon me, Bassanio. Nerissa, and pardon me, my gentle Graciano, for that same scrubbed boy, the doctor's clerk, did give me this. They are not revealing that they were there in the court. They are only telling that they took it from those people. Portia, you are all amazed. You are all amazed, surprised. Here is a letter. Read it at your leisure. Here is a letter. Read it at your leisure. Leisure. At your free time. It comes from Padua, from Bellario. There you shall find that Portia was the doctor, Nerissa there, her clerk. So, in that letter you will find that the young doctor was none other than Portia, and the clerk of Portia, the young doctor, was none other than Nerissa. Lorenzo here shall witness, I started journeys as soon as you left the house. But now returned, and we also returned, now only. I have not yet entered to my room. She's already in the house, her own house. Antonio, you are welcome, and I have better news in store for you. Antonio, I have good news for you. Than you expect, unseal this letter soon. This letter, unseal, open. There you shall find three of your argosies are richly come to a harbor suddenly. So three of his vessels, ships, have returned to the harbor. You shall not know by what strange accident I chanced on this letter. You will not know how I got this letter. You shall not know. You should not know, or you will not know. It is not your burden to find out how I got the letter. You shouldn't know. Antonio, I am dumb. I am wordless, speechless. I am surprised. Bassanio, were you the doctor? I knew you not. Were you the doctor? Were you that young lawyer? And I knew you not. Were you the clerk? Graciano. Antonio, sweet lady, you have given me life and living. You have given me life and living. How did she give the life?
By saving him
from the?
Shylock.
From Shylock. And living through this letter. For here, I read for certain that my ships are safe. My ships are safely come to road. My ships are back to the harbor. Portia. How now, Lorenzo? My clerk had some good comforts too for you. Lorenzo, for you also we have some good news. Erisa, hey. I will give him without a fee. I'll give them free. All that news I'll give. What is the good news for Lorenzo? The gift deed. The gift deed that was made by
Shylock.
There do I give you and Jessica from the rich Jew a special deed of gift, a special document of gift after his death of all he dies possessed of. You will get a gift of all that is possessed by Shylock after his death. Lorenzo, fair ladies, you drop manna in the way of starved people. You drop manna. What is manna? Manna is the food that was dropped by God for the people walking in the desert, the Israelites. In the Old Testament, which is a sacred book for Shylock, there is a story of Israel people who were working in Egypt as slaves were set free, and they escaped from Egypt by walking through the Red Sea. They walk through the sea and they come to a desert, and in the desert they are all hungry, and God rains down manna, a sort of meat, and they live by that. So just as God has dropped down manna for the hungry Israelites, you have dropped down good news for the starved person. Portia, it is almost morning, so they are coming to the sense of time. So it's almost morning, and yet I am sure you are not satisfied. I'm sure yet you want to speak a lot of these events at full. Let us go in and charge us there upon interrogatories. What are the interrogatories? Questions. Interrogatory sentence. Have you heard? Questions, different kinds. Question word sentences are there. They are called interrogatories. So you can ask and clarify for yourself. Let us go in and we will answer all things faithfully. All things faithfully, truly, we will answer them without saying lies. Graciano, let it be so. Okay. While I live, I will fear no other thing so sore as keeping safe Nerissa's ring. Rhyming, you see. I will keep no other thing safe as Nerissa's ring. I will keep it safe. So that concludes the drama. The fifth act we don't need to study, but it is good to read through whenever you are studying the drama, so that you have the full view, full idea for the total comprehension of the drama. Now for your exam, you need to study 1, 2, 3, 4 acts. Fifth is nothing actually, is it not? But they have removed fifth. Instead of that, they should have removed the second. But maybe they know that we will read through fully, therefore they removed just the fifth one. 90 you have studied, 1 and 2, you must be thorough with it, or at least you have studied it one full year. And now 3rd and 4th, and most questions that you need to answer, maybe 50% at least, will come from 10th portions. So you need to have both the workbooks or the full workbook. Do you have in the same workbook all the 4? Okay, so I will send you today, either in the afternoon or in the evening, the fourth act notes, kindly copy it onto your workbook and I will see them on Monday. Okay? Did you all hear? Okay, you tell me.